Our first speaker is Anindita Nayak. Anindita is also known as a streetlight warrior because she's on a mission to map all the street lights in the city. So she's here to tell her tale on why she took that initiative and show the experiences of a project.
Hi everyone, thanks to Vidya for the introduction. I am Anindita and I'm here to talk about one of the initiatives that I took earlier this year. I moved to Bangalore a couple of years back for work. I use a two-wheeler to commute. My workplace is on the Outer Ring Road. I'm not sure how many of you've heard of Outer Ring Road or have been there. There are about 1 million people who go to work every day. There are a lot of tech parks, so a lot of people commute on that street. Every evening when I drive back home, I'm often scared about running into potholes or hitting a pedestrian. And the state of lights is extremely poor and abysmal along that stretch. So I always had the feeling that it was really bad, but I wanted to find out how bad exactly. So I decided to map all the streetlights in my vicinity and along my commute route. So I started from home and I traced everything towards my office and then went and covered a couple of more areas too. So while deciding to do this, I decided to use OSM. I'm a new user of OSM. So this was my first time where I was using this too. And OSM was a perfect platform for me. So I ended up mapping close to 1,000 street lights, covering about 15 kilometers back and forth from Marathali to Silk Boat. Oh, thanks. Silk Boat, and then covered a couple of areas near my house and an HSR as well. So for this mapping activity, I had to do it on foot or on my bike or in a car, and had to do it at night. One of the lessons that I learned is that do not venture out alone in dark corners at night. But unfortunately, I had to do this. So let me tell you about what tools I used while doing this. I ended up using Go Maps. It's a fantastic iOS app. It let me add streetlights, add nodes, and update the status of it. So after mapping about 1,000 of them, I used Overpass API to get all my GeoJSON files, and then I used Mapbox to visualize it. So I want to show you a sneak peek into what the map looks like. So over here, you can see all the way from the right hand, the top right, to the midsection of the left side. Those are basically the lights that I marked. The orange spots are the ones that work, and the gray spots are the ones that don't work. Here is just another snapshot of the same data itself, visualized differently. So as you can see, most parts along this route, they're actually dark. You can just see parts of HSR near Iblur, which is brightly lit, but the rest of them, all the way from Marathali to Iblur, it's fairly poorly lit. So I'll take you to one other peep into one of these areas too. So Agra Lake, it's a massive lake that just comes next to HSR layout. And just the lights along the water are lit, but everywhere else around the lake, it's completely dark. There's absolutely no light. The only source of lights are from oncoming vehicles or like neighboring buildings. And this area has been dark for like several months and even years. I'm pretty sure it's been dark for like a couple of years. Now this is another stretch along the Belandur Road itself. So Belandur Road, there are two flyovers. There's one flyover where only one side of the street is lit, and there's one flyover that comes later where both the sides are completely dark, no lights at all. They're just lights from the apartments and neighboring buildings. That's it. So this is what the scorecard looks like for all of these areas. Like if you consider HSR, that's the best area that we have right now, and just half the lights work, function there. And if you look at Belandur, just 20%. 20% of the lights work. Marathali gets a little better, and it does marginally better, and it stands at 30%. Few of the inner areas of HSR and towards Silkpur, that's about 40%. So this is what does current status of streetlights look like in Bangalore. And Yeah, like, so if you're interested in checking the map out, it's a little interactive. You can go to my, you can go to this link. You can also go to my blog to read how exactly I went about doing this. There are proper steps mentioned around how did I use Go Maps, how did I end up exporting this data and then visualizing it on Mapbox. And at the end of it, I started off with the simple task of mapping lights, and honestly, like OSM was like the best platform to do that provided that flexibility, unlike Google Maps, etc. So, yeah, this is you can check out these links here. And if you want to reach out to me on this initiative, or if you want to contribute to it, you can reach out to me on Twitter or on email. Thank you.